into a horrible cauldron of violence and atrocity. I spent a lot of time in the Congo, and I see what is happening on the bodies of women and girls. It is femicide. There are 500,000 women who have been raped in the Congo, and the rapes do not end. They are not moved to change the situation in the Congo. Change comes from the bottom up. Change comes from the people. That is the only place it will ever come from. And if you all are afraid, you will be paralyzed. What is there to be afraid of? We are at risk of seeing more Iraqis die, more Afghanis die, people dying in Congo. 6 million people have died in the Congo in 12 years, and the war has not ended. And that war is an economic war, which is fueled by the West and the corporations who take the resources and rob the resources and pillage them and destroy the women to get them. And we benefit from them. So we're all part of that war. So I urge you, I think now more than ever, organize, demonstrate, protest, gather. We have to stop being divided. We have to start being intense. And we have to start making everyone really uncomfortable. Thank you very much. And now the only path to sustain the power of this country is tragically military hegemony. Maybe, in fact, and I say this to the Obama administration, I am calling out to the Obama, maybe we are lost here in this country right now. Maybe we need to ask questions of people in the world. Maybe other people know things we don't know. Maybe they know what they need, and they know how to accomplish what they need.
Country.